Do you know which filler lasts the longest? Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. So we're gonna talk about dermal fillers today and how long do they last. There's four main types of dermal fillers in the United States today. There's the hyaluronic acid fillers. There are some extremes of lightweight ones and ones that last a little bit longer. They're heavier or larger size. But in general, think of anywhere from 6 months to 18 months is a good round figure. So that's hyaluronic acids like your Restylane products, your Juvederms, Belotero. The next product is the only permanent one we have, which is PMMA or Bellafill, which was Artifill prior to that. Artical and Artiplast in Canada and a few other countries. So Artifill is the only permanent one we have. And remember, with permanent, doesn't mean you're not going to age, but certainly what you see, the people who have it, and it, when it's used appropriately, they age much slower, the face stays higher if it's used in the upper face, and the skin just looks better over time. The next two are really biostimulators. Number one, of course, is Sculptra. So if we think of PLLA, Sculptra, that is a collagen stimulator, goes in with a water, very unique. No other product goes in with a water as a carrier. And that product is FDA approved the last 2 years. Here's the reality on that. They stopped the study to get it approved at 2 years, and people, they did follow some of them out beyond 2 years. In general, a 2 to 5 year product when it's used appropriately initially and patients have gotten the level, because it takes a couple treatments up front to get people where they need to be. And now the fourth one is Radiesse calcium hydroxyl apatite, which again has collagen stimulating properties, but also it initially fills with carboxymethyl cellulose as the carrier. And the 70% of that syringe is a carboxymethyl cellulose, goes in about maybe 6 to 8 weeks, maybe 3 months at most. And then the calcium seems to maintain longer. I usually say with the collagen stimulating effect, anywhere from 8 to 18 months, somewhere in there. So those are four different types. I think one of the things when we think about longevity that's very important, there's really four factors. Let's go through those now. Number one is skin damage. The more skin damage there is, not only is it more technical to use the fillers, you often have to combine these products, but the more that people typically need. Number two is hollows. A face that's very hollow, they need more product, and so longevity becomes confusing because a lot of times people don't get enough because it's expensive, and when there's a lot of hollows and you just do a few syringes, it's really underwhelming. You need usually combinations of procedures and multiple vials. Doing anywhere from 5 to 20 vials would be pretty normal. Number three is placement. You can put fillers in where you don't even see anything. Either they're too deep, they're too peripheral, they're not in the line of sight. So the depth and where they're placed and how they're layered will depend on the result that you get and the longevity of the product. Movement areas, they're gonna burn off quicker. Areas deeper on the bone, they're going to stay longer, but it needs to be in the appropriate place. Remember, there's not always bone to place it, such as the preauricular area. There's no bone beneath there, it's mainly parotid. The fourth factor on longevity really is expectations, because if someone has an expectation of a lot of filler, a very high cheek, not only they're gonna need more, but when it comes down, when it starts to wear off, or as they age, they're gonna want it touched up quickly. So while someone might be happy for 2 or 3 years because they want a more subtler result, then it might last longer in their mind. Somebody that really likes it topped up and when they see a nice result, they might even want a little more within weeks or months. It's not that it wore off, it's that their eye became used to it. They got used to their look. And a lot of people don't remember how big their lips were, how high their cheeks were when they were young and then when there was a lot of fat. So those are four factors, and then the four different really types of fillers that we have in the United States today, and a lot of those are around the world as well. Let us know what's your favorite product, how long does it last for you, which ones do you like to use in the comments below. Join us over on our Instagram, and also keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.